You are actively trying to become pregnant and you have missed your periods. The CAR test is positive. You have even got a beta HCG done and the values are slowly increasing. You are super excited and can't wait for the scanning to be done to confirm that everything is normal and all right. When you go for a scanning, your gynecologist or the radiologist, whoever is doing the scanning, tells you that there is indeed a gestational sac inside the uterus, but there is no fetal pole and at times there is no yolk sac. You are asked to come back after a couple of weeks for a repeat scan. You are so depressed. You can't wait for the 2 weeks period to be over. After 2 weeks, when the repeat scan is done again, the results are the same. No fetal pole and at times no yolk sac too. The doctor writes a diagnosis as failed pregnancy and embryonic gestation or blighted ova. Now, what exactly is an embryonic pregnancy or blighted ova? In this video, we will discuss everything about an embryonic pregnancy or blighted ovum in detail. So stay tuned and watch this video till the end. Hello everyone, welcome back to your own YouTube channel, Mind Body Tonic. And this is Dr. Sita with you again. In this video, as I told you in the introduction, we will be discussing about an embryonic pregnancy, which was previously known as blighted ovum. Actually, more than 50% of all pregnancies end in failure, mostly within the first 3 months of pregnancy. And blighted ovum or an embryonic pregnancy is one of the most common reasons for early pregnancy failure. What exactly is this an embryonic pregnancy? In an embryonic pregnancy, just as in normal pregnancy, the sperm and the egg unite to form the zygote. As you all know, the fertilized egg is called the zygote. And the zygote starts dividing and the gestational sac is formed and some amount of chorionic villi or the placental tissue is also formed, which results in a positive beta HCG and the formation of a gestational sac. But unfortunately, the embryo and at times the yolk sac doesn't develop. What is this yolk sac? Yolk sac is a structure which feeds the embryo and helps the embryo to grow during the early weeks of pregnancy. Now, why does an embryonic pregnancy develop? Mostly, it is due to some chromosomal abnormality of either the egg or the sperm or both. It may be due to poor quality of the egg or sperm too. Nature recognizes that it is abnormal and stops it from developing further. As I mentioned before, more than 50% of early pregnancy failures are due to an embryonic pregnancy. How do you know that you have an embryonic pregnancy? As I mentioned before, many women experience a missed period, a positive pregnancy test, and many have symptoms of early pregnancy because the hormone beta HCG or human chorionic gonadotropin is being secreted by the placental tissue for some time at least. However, the scan report shows that there is no fetal pole and at times no yolk sac also, and repeat scan done a week or 10 days later or sometimes 2 weeks later shows the same findings. At times, even before the scanning is being done, some women start experiencing some amount of spotting. But many women do not experience any symptoms of failed pregnancy at all. Actually, we tell the patients to wait for 2 weeks or 3 weeks period just to ensure that the patient has not conceived late and we do not miss out on an early normal pregnancy. Now, what can we do once we diagnose an embryonic pregnancy? Is there any way to correct it? Is there any injection or medicine which can make this anembryonic pregnancy grow properly and have an embryo develop properly? Sadly, there is no way that you can make an anembryonic pregnancy grow into a proper pregnancy. And another important point which I want to stress upon is there is nothing that you could have possibly done to prevent an anembryonic pregnancy from occurring except maybe improve the quality of your egg or sperm by improving your lifestyle, diet and other things which I always mention in many of my videos. Now, how do you manage an embryonic pregnancy? Most of the time, bleeding happens spontaneously or with the help of some tablets taken either orally or inserted vaginally. And then you wait for the bleeding to stop to get a repeat scanning and confirm that all the products have been expelled out. Only very rarely the products are not expelled completely and we need to do a dilatation and curettage, which is commonly known as DNC. Now, the question that is in the mind of all couples is, will an embryonic pregnancy or blighted ovum recur again? What can we do to prevent it from recurring? The good news is, blighted ovum or anembryonic pregnancy do not have a tendency to repeat in successful pregnancy like many other causes which have a tendency to recur in subsequent pregnancies. However, as I mentioned before, you can indeed do whatever you can to improve the quality of the egg and sperm. And I have mentioned in many of my videos the various methods by which we can improve the quality of the egg and sperm. Good and nutritious food, proper and adequate exercise, and other positive lifestyle changes have a very important role in improving the quality of both the egg and the sperm. Other than that, there is nothing that you need to do or nothing that you can possibly do. The last question that people have is, how long do we need to wait after an anembryonic pregnancy to become pregnant again? Usually, we advise patients to wait for at least 2 to 3 months before attempting another pregnancy. However, in certain special circumstances, you can attempt for another pregnancy after a month. Your doctor will be the best person to guide you as to what to do. So I hope that all your doubts regarding anembryonic pregnancy or blighted ovum are now cleared. There are many other types of pregnancy-related issues, especially in the first trimester. Biochemical pregnancy, about which I have already made a video both in English and in Malayalam. Threatened miscarriage, missed miscarriage, vesiclomole or molar pregnancy, ectopic pregnancy, so on and so forth. Some of these we have already discussed and others we will be discussing in the near future. Please do share this knowledge gained with your friends, family and contacts. Till I see you again with another video, take care of yourself and your loved ones and stay blessed.